What's up, guys? Dabndaddo here today with you with Weld.com, explaining the differences of a Lincoln Precision TIG 225 versus a Lincoln Precision TIG 375. And obviously there are some big differences and some not so big differences. So I'll hop over and I'll show you those. So I will show you what the main difference is in between the 375 and the 225. So 375, we have quite a few knobs, switches here. The 225 only has three knobs. This one, AC balance, the pulse frequency, and the post flow. And of course, your main amperage. However, on the 375, we have quite a few more, and I will show you what each and every one of them do.
First, we need to make sure that it is on TIG welding mode and not stick. Then the next switch is minimum output, and that controls on how low your arc will actually start. And if you move the display switch, you can see and you can adjust that setting. Otherwise, that display switch will show normal amperage. Remote is foot pedal setting, obviously our maximum output, and then our post flow setting.
I'll be setting my gas to about 33 CFH.
First will be the AC balance knob, which controls the AC current. So we don't really need it because we are on DC negative to weld stainless steel to begin with. We will be on two-step mode for our foot pedal. Our pulse will be on. There's off and there is on. And you can see how the light indicates the speed of the pulse. So if you crank it way up, it flashes real fast. It's actually how fast the amperage is adjusting. On time, 60%, background is 40, downslope, and post flow is there at about 10. Let's first begin by setting the main amperage to about 170, 160-ish. And then we don't really need the penetration. That's AC balance. It is on two-step. We're going to turn the pulser on. And here the flashing light shows on how fast it is actually pulsing. Here the pulse frequency knob is how we change how fast that pulse pulses. As I turn down, that light turns way down, slows way down. That's about where I'm going to leave it. On time switch is how long that pulse is at the peak of that pulse, the hottest time. So we'll do 60%. The background current peak is about how much amperage of your total amperage will be on at the low end. Downslope, we don't need the downslope. Don't like the downslope. And post flow, I always run it at about 10 seconds or greater just to ensure that the tungsten is nice and clean and protected as it cools off. And again, we are on DC negative. So today, I'll be using a CK Worldwide Flex Lock torch. It is by far my favorite torch because it is super handy. You can get it in any tight space with the swivel feature. Super ergonomical. You can see how well it fits in my hand right here. I don't know. There's just been no spot I haven't really been able to get it in. And then here's the tungsten I'll be using today. This is a 332. 2% lengthenated or a blue tungsten, a number 8 cup with a gas lens on it, not a standard collet body and a collet, but this is a gas lens, which really helps the gas flow much, much better. I'll be using two little squares of 304 stainless steel with 316 filler rod. I'll throw a couple tacks on here and then kind of go from there. Okay. Apparently, I am not perfect like anybody else. So, wow. Just wow. Decided to stick it, take it for a nice swim. But I'll smash it back down to make it nice flat again. Hey, there we go. All right. I got my two blocks of stainless tacked up. And I like to tack it in that particular way. That way I have more areas to weld. There's six places to weld if you look at both sides. And so here we go. I will show you what it looks like. Now remember, this is the pulse feature. So why? This is why you see the flashing light. It's not my foot controlled. It's all the machine doing that. Remember that little tiny green flashing light and that setting I had set? That's what you see here. Waiting for the post flow to cool down the weld and to protect it, as well as to protect the tungsten from getting any contaminants or too many oxides. And there it is. Nothing special, but there's a good example of how it runs, especially on the pulse setting. And here you go. So I welded the other side of it just to give you a little bit better view of it. Nothing crazy. Now let's switch things up a little bit and let's start welding aluminum. So here we have the main polarity switch. We need to switch it to AC. AC balance is set to 70-ish percent.
So we have 1/4 inch, 3/16 aluminum, 50 series. That's what it appears to be. I set the welder right on over here. I set it to AC. I've got no pulse, so it is just gonna be a straight current on AC. But right here is the balance switch, and I've got it set to about 70% on the negative side, EN side, about 70%, which is gonna allow me a good amount of cleaning, but not too much. So you can see I had a little bit of trouble right here. Not too bad, but it was just a little bit dirty. So I gotta take the oxide layer off, you know, the aluminum. Just gonna give it a quick brush with the wire brush. There we are. Nice and clean, nice and clean. Now, let me go ahead and do a weld out pulse. So just be regular old AC 60 hertz because it's a transformer machine. That's why it weighs over 500 pounds. So you can really tell, go ahead, listen to this part. You can really tell a difference when there's no pulser on or active.
I also wanted to show you the difference of changing the AC balance knob. So here you can see the first weld on the left-hand side. I set it to 70% EN. So good amount of cleaning, but not too much. Where far right side is 50%. So it is, the knob would be straight up and down at balanced and way too much cleaning. It destroys the tungsten. It blows it off. That's why that is so dirty. And you can actually see a hole underneath that weld because it didn't get enough penetration. Where the center one is on auto. That would be the green area on the Lincoln Precision TIG 375 AC balance knob. That's where the machine thinks it knows its best and it does its own thing. And you just sit down and weld. Preferably, I don't like running on auto because I don't like the outcome of it. However, I understand some other people may. So just to recap, the Lincoln Precision TIG 375 versus the Lincoln Precision TIG 225 really doesn't have too many differences. The 225 only has the three knobs, which is the AC balance, the pulse frequency, and the post flow on top of the main amperage, of course. Where the 375 has many more switches, the AC balance, the two-step, four-step, pulse frequency, on time, background, current percentage, downslope, post flow. There's many more adjustments for the 375. Also, the biggest difference would be the 375 maxes out at about 420 amps, where the 225 is right there in about the 225, 230 amps.
Thanks for watching today. Be sure to ask us if you have any other questions. Don't forget to check out the Weld app coming out very soon. That way you and I can all connect globally in this welding community.